And joining us now to give us a better idea of those efforts is State Representative Robert Asensio.
Mr. Asensio is the first Puerto Rican elected to the State House in 50 years. Welcome, Representative Asensio. Thank you so much for being here tonight.
Thank you.
First thing we want to know is, what kind of communication have you had with your loved ones and others on the island tonight?
Limited. Some of my family members I've been able to communicate with. They're fine. But there are others that are still unaccounted for. And we have people going out to the different little towns to see if they can find them.
We mentioned that President Trump has declared a disaster area there, which, of course, we're familiar with here in South Florida. That opens the way for federal funds. What kind of help does Puerto Rico need from the federal government?
Assistance with the complete infrastructure. Their power grid is totally shot. I believe about 100% of the island is without power. And they're going to have a complete restoration of their power grid. On top of that, the utilities, certainly fuel supplies, resupplies of food, and just about every, I equate it to basically a civil affairs type of mission, humanitarian mission that we're going to have to deploy or employ in Puerto Rico on the island.
The mayor of San Juan specifically mentioning the help that Puerto Rico is getting from New York, from Houston, as they're still dealing with the aftermath of Hurricane Harvey there. What are you seeing as far as help coming from right here in South Florida? I know several flights took off this morning with supplies,
yes,
and warehouses are filling up with things to send.
Well, I was at a couple places today where they're actually doing collection sites. There's a tremendous swell of people wanting to help. Amazing, because we're still recovering from Irma. There's large containers today. There was one in Kendall, East Les, then in Encanto, one of the restaurants, tomorrow, Ana G. Mendez, and then also at Carlos Urbizu in the university. There'll be collection sites. The community's coming together as a whole to be able to provide food, water, perishables, clothing. I'm understanding that a lot of people in Puerto Rico in affected areas lost just about everything.
This is just so difficult, and it couldn't come at a worse time to have the back-to-back storms on top of a financial crisis in Puerto Rico that's been ongoing for years. How do you get out of this mess?
Well, it's going to take a lot of work. I was on the phone with one of the congressmen of our delegation in the state of Florida a couple days ago, and subsequently I've been on the phone with a couple more. And they're already beginning to craft language for an economic package that's going to help Puerto Rico pay for the grid to get back up, so that people can live on the island. Because you think about it, without power, how are they going to go to work?
Yeah.
How are they going to live? Where are they going to go? Florida becomes a destination of choice for many. So we also have to prepare at the state level for those that are going to come. We're going to have a mass transfer of people. So the state has begun the process speaking about what do we need to do and who do we need to task to ensure that we can accommodate those that are coming over. Today I was told that the House of Representatives, under our speaker, there will be a task force created to look at these issues and assist in whatever ways we can from the state, the legislative body, that is.
Do you feel the support is there at the state level for people that might come to the United States, because Puerto Rico is just not exactly the best place to live right now while they're recovering? Is there that support here that you would like there to be?
Well, I haven't spoken to all leaders,
yeah,
and I haven't spoken to all our elected officials in the legislature, but I believe it's mounting. Everyone I've spoken to or with has been very supportive of the idea of we have to do something. This is not what if, this is a reality of when.
And you also haven't spoken to all of your loved ones just yet, so of course we send our well wishes to all of them. We hope they're fine. We hope you hear from them very soon.
Thank you very much.
State Representative Robert Asensio, thank you very much, sir. Please keep us posted.
Will do. Thank you.
Okay.